I started 10 or 12 years old, and my parents wanted me to learn how to play piano. And I didn't like piano. I wanted to play drums. So they asked to beat up all the pots and pans, you know, in the kitchen. Like, that's it. So, later on, I still tried to get interested in piano, but that wasn't any good, you know. My mother used to give me piano lessons, you know. But nothing ever happened. I'd tinker with the piano every now and then, see. But later on, and I just liked the looks of a saxophone. So I wound up with a soprano. And I had the soprano, and a curved soprano, see. And I heard so much about Sidney Bechet. And my sister knew him when he was playing in Boston at the Burleigh's house called Jimmy Cooper's Black and White Show. So I got up enough nerve, which I did at that particular time. I had a lot of nerve, so I went back. I had to see him. I had my soprano on my arm, and I had cut off one of my mother's sleeves of her coat and put the soprano in it. So, he said, "What's that?" I said, "That's saxophone." He said, "Can you play it?" I said, "Yes." I only had it about 2 days. I said, "Yes." I sit down and play. So I played what I could. So he kind of liked it. So he, you know, told me a few things. And I never expected that I'd wind up playing with him 2-3 years later. So finally, I got rid of the soprano and got alto. And then, something like 1925, I went to New York just for a visit, you know. So I would come to New York and get educated, right? You know, I would go into jam sessions. They didn't call them jam sessions at the time. They called them cutting contests. And you'd walk up 7th Avenue, a person would hand you a card, say, jam session, that cutting contest, rather. Duke Ellington was one of the judges, and Fats Waller, and Fletcher Henderson, James B. Johnson, Willie Lyon Smith, Willie Gant, all these piano players. It started with pianos, and they end up with tubas, trumpets, saxophones, trombones, everything. So it was a big honor to get cut. They call them cutting contests. If you got cut, then you were real known, see? But it was educational. So I would get all these ideas and go back to Boston and come back to New York, go back to Boston. Duke used to come to Boston every summer. See, Duke originally had a six-piece band. And in the summertime, he would leave New York and he would go up to New England and he would augment his band probably to 9 or 10. And I used to just go to the dances, listening. And I was working at a little club called the Black and White Club. I used to make $2.50 a night. But just like I said, I would probably make $30 tips. And they used to come by every night. And I'd play, I used to walk around the club with my horn, and people would dance, I'd follow you around the dance hall, waiting for you to put somebody in the horn, you know. And he'd always ask me to come on, go to New York with him. I used to tell him, "I'm not ready. I'm not ready," he said, "not ready." So when he started augmenting his band at the Cotton Club, and I think it was 27, he asked me again, and I said, "No." So I suggested Harry Carney to him, you know. He was working in New York at the Bamboo Inn. So he went down, picked up Harry Carney, and I suggested Bon and Big Odd know me and Simeon, but he'd taken Big Odd. And then I joined him in 28.